Hello everyone, good morning students. Dear students, in previous class we take and discuss some important chapter related to your syllabus. Now in previous class we discuss about the graph, and now in today's class we take and discuss a very important chapter of your syllabus, which is exponents and powers. Dear students, we just revised that chapter because we already discussed about that chapter so many times, but we simplify all the important, we discuss all the chapters. Now we are going to discuss about exponent and power. So before that, first of all, we are going to take and discuss some important law, basics, laws of exponents, of exponents and power. So first of all, we discuss some important laws of exponents and powers. Okay, some important laws of exponents and power. Now look, dear friend, you already know that if a, we have a to the power n into a to the power n. Suppose that we have a to the power m into a to the power n, then in that condition we can write as a to the power m plus n. If the bases are same, then power is to be added. Okay, second thing is that if we have a to the power m upon a to the power n, then we can write a to the power m minus n. This is also a very important and basic laws of exponents. Okay, now if we have a upon b to the power n, then we can write a to the power n upon b to the power n. Sorry, b to the power n. Okay, this is also a very important laws of exponents, and one is the most important. If we a upon b to whole power minus n, then we can write b upon a. This is b upon a to whole power plus n. B upon a to whole power plus n. This is very important and laws of exponents. And dear Sandhya, we also have if a to the power n to whole power n. So what I do, dear friends, so we just multiplying their power. So we write as a to the power m into n. And if anywhere we have a to the power minus n, then we can write 1 upon a to the power plus n. Okay. Or if we have 1 upon a to the power minus n, then if we go take in numerator, so we can write a to the power plus n. So these are also some important basic laws of exponent. So in that chapter, dear son, we discuss all the important basic laws of exponents and simply solving the some important questions based on this topic. Okay, let's see. We take some important questions based on these laws of exponents. Now look, so we take some important question. Evaluate each of the following. Take some important questions. Evaluate each of the following. Okay, we take some important question, and the question is evaluate each of the following. Okay, and the first part of this question, 3 power minus 1 plus 4 power minus 1 plus 5 power minus 1 to whole power 2, and second one is thing, this is minus 2 by 3 to whole power minus 2 to whole power 2. Just simplify them also. Third part of this question is what? 8 to the power minus 1 into 5 to the power 3 upon 2 to the power minus 4. Fourth part of this question, 5 power minus 1 into 2 power minus 1 into multiplied by 6 power minus 1. Now look, so first of all we take and discuss some basics questions of your syllabus. Okay, now let's see its solution. First of all, we take and solve the first part of the question. First of all, we write the given expression. Write the given expression, which is what? 3 power minus 1, 4 power minus 1, 5 power minus 1 to whole power 2. So what I do, first of all we simplify in within the brackets, we simplify these values. Okay, look, we can write 1 upon 3 plus 1 upon 4 plus 1 upon 4 to whole power 2, because of since if we have a power minus n, then we can write 1 upon 3 to power n. If we have a to the power minus n, dear students, then we can write 1 upon a to the power n. Okay, this is the very important concepts related to exponents and powers. Now, look, we simplify them. So we take the LCM of their denominator, which is what? We take the LCM 3, 4, 60. We take LCM of the denominator is what? 60. Now, we dividing them to 3 to 21, the 20 here, plus this is 15, 1 the 15 is there, 12, 1 the 12 is there. Okay, now we adding and squaring them. If we adding them, so we get as 20, 15, 12, 12, then we get 5 to 7. This is 47. This is 47. Okay, 47. So we have 47 upon 60 whole power 2. Now you know that if we split the brackets, then we get 47 square upon 60 square. So we have 47 into 47 upon this is 3,600. We multiply 47 into 47 upon 3600. This is your required solution of the given question. So dear student, in this way you can solve each and every questions of your NCERT exercise based on these topics. This is one of the most important questions of your syllabus. So please please dear students, do more and more practices of that type of questions. After that you can solve each and every questions of your NCERT exercise based on these topics. Okay dear students, now we take and discuss some other important next part of this question. Let's see. Let's see the second part of this question. We have minus 2 upon 3 to whole power minus 2 to whole power 2. Look, what I do for that? So first of all we get this brackets, and we know that since a to the n power n to power n is equal to a to the power m to n. This is the कौन से? नाव। We break this bracket, so we get minus 2 by 3 to the power 2 to the, this is minus 4. This is was minus 4. Okay, now what I do? So now you know that a very important law of exponent, a upon b to the power minus n, then we can b upon a, then it's converted into the plus n. So we can write minus 2 by 3 to whole power plus 4. Okay, to whole power plus 4. Now we simplify them and we get our result. So we can write minus 3 by 2, minus 3 by 2, and minus 3 by 2. So now 3 is a 9 and the 81 is minus plus plus. This is in plus 81 upon 16. So plus 81 upon 16. Is the required solution of the given question. Okay, so this is the method, dear students, to solve that type of questions. So please, please, dear students, do more and more practices of that type of questions, and after that you can solve each and every questions of your NCERT exercise based on these topics. Now we take and solve some other important question. Third, next part of the question. Let's see. Now, we take and solve the third part of this question. First of all, we write given given expression, which is what? Minus 1 by 3 upon 2 minus 2 power minus 4. Okay? Now, this is 8 power 1 right as it is. So 1 upon 8 power minus 1, we can write 5 power 3 upon 8 power plus 1 into, we transfer that in numerator, so we get 2 power plus 4. Now look, we can write 2 power 4 into 5 power 3 upon, we can write 8 in the form of 2 power 3. 2 to the power 3 because of 2 to the 4 to the 8 to the 16, 2 to the 4 to the 8. Now here we apply the laws of exponent, which is what? Which is equal to 2 power 4 minus 3 into 5 power 3 right as it is. And you know that if a power m upon a power n, so we can write a power m minus n. Okay? So now here we have 2 power 4 minus 3, that is 1, into 5 power 3. So we get 2 into 5, 5 is 25 to the 125 to the 250. So this is the required solution of the given question. So please, dear student, this do more and more practices on that type of question. Now, dear student, we take and solve the last part of this question. Let's see.
we have
six power minus one. Okay. Now, look.
First of all, we apply that law of exponent. If we have a power minus n, then we can add a 1 upon a to power n. We first of all we apply
that concept. Okay. Now,
we can write 1 upon 5 to power 1 into here 1 upon 2 power 1, one never be right on the power of any number, into this is 1 upon 6.
Now, we just multiply, we simplify them.
So we get what? 1 upon 5 to the, this is 10, into 1 upon 6, that is 1 upon 60 is the required solution of the given question.
So in this way, you apply the laws of exponents. This is a very important conceptual question. So please, dear students,
do more and more practices of that type of questions. And after that, you can solve each and every question of hands, RT exercise based on these topics. Okay?
Now, we take and solve some important questions. Okay,
one more question. We will wait.
Evaluate
minus 1 upon 3.
Sorry, 1 upon 3
power, 1 upon 3 power minus 1. Plus 1 upon 4 to the power
minus 1
in whole to the power minus 1.
Okay, now let's see solution. What is the process, dear students? Dear students, in that type of question, first of all, we solve within the brackets, the values in this brackets. Means, first of all, we simplify that values. And for that, we apply the concept, you know that?
A power minus n is equal to 1 upon n, 1 plus n, or a upon b to whole power minus n, then we can write b upon a to the power plus n.
This is also very important laws of exponent. So here we apply that laws first of all.
So look, so here we can write 3 upon 1 to power plus 1, 4 upon 1 to power plus 1, and minus 1 write as it is. Now look, so 3 power 1 is 3, 4 power 1 is 4, to whole power minus 1, so we get as 7 to the power minus 1, so we break the bracket to 7 power minus 1.
Dear students, 7 to the power minus 1 means that what?
1 upon 7, so this is the required solution.
Okay, this is a very important question. So
now,
dear friends,
similarly you can solve all that type of question like that. Evaluate minus 4 to the power 5 divided by
minus 4 to the power 8.
So what I do for that?
So now look,
first of all we minus 4 to power 5 divided by minus 4 to power 8. So we can write minus 4 power 5 minus 8. So minus 4 to the power what? Minus 3. So we can write 1 upon minus 4 power 3. So we get 1 upon minus 64. Okay.
So in this way, this way you can solve each and every question of the NCERT exercise based on this topic. So first of all, you clear the concept of laws of exponents and solve your NCERT exercise. Okay, dear students. Now, in next class, we take and discuss some other important questions of your syllabus based on your new topic. Okay, now thanks to all.